A camera is always necessary to view the content of a 3D scene. It defines how your 3D model is projected into a 2D coordinate space, which, in the end, would be the 2D surface of your screen. In the Navigator, you can find a scene camera item that Design Studio has already created for you. The 2D view shows what the camera is seeing. As a default, the scene camera is pointed straight toward the robot along the Z-axis. When looking at the view from the side, we can see that the camera's center point is where the robot's toes are. By moving the camera up and closer and rotating it, we can see the robot from a different angle. You can change the direction of the camera in any way you like within the 3D scene. Try moving the camera to different places to see how the view changes. You can also create transition animations with cameras. Let's create a simple transition for the robot when the user opens the application. First, change the 3D view back to the bird's-eye perspective. Remember that you can always undo your changes by selecting Edit and Undo, or pressing Ctrl and Z. Now, move the camera to the position where you want it to be when the transition starts. I want to create a small zoom-out transition, so I move the camera closer to the robot. This is the starting point. Next, open the timeline view and select the plus icon. You don't need to make any changes to the properties. Select Close. Select the yellow playhead arrow and move it up on the timeline. This determines how long the transition lasts. You can change this later. I set it to 400. Timeline Editor has a built-in recorder for events, called auto-keying. Enable auto-keying by clicking the record icon on the timeline view. Now, move the camera where you want it to be at the end of the animation. Click the auto key again to stop recording. In the timeline view, click to expand the scene camera rows. You can see that the timeline has generated X, Y, and Z coordinates where the yellow playhead is. These are the coordinates where the camera ends up. You can preview the transition by clicking the green play button on the timeline view. In the 2D view, I can see the robot transitioning accordingly. And when I preview the design, the scene starts with the transition. If you want to make the transition slower or quicker, simply move the keyframes on the timeline. And there we have it. A 3D design with a camera transition, light, and slider for user interaction.